Scream surprised a lot of people with the release of their latest single, Loaded, the result of a collaboration between the band and Andy Weatherall. Probably one of their strongest singles to date and a far cry from Velocity Girl, it's finally given the band the much wider audience that they deserve.
Every time we've released a new record, it's kind of like been different from the last record. We've always kept changing, so I suppose that's the constant thing about the group, that it always changes. For a band like us, to make a record like that is quite a big risk in a way. You know, you could be in serious danger of losing, you know, any support that you have and people not buying your records anymore. But we don't care, you know, because our attitude has always been like you, basically, with every record we've ever made and every time we've played on stage. We've never really cared what the audience thought, you know, so I don't think it's a cop-out. We've never had that kind of attitude. It's always been an aggressive attitude, you know. Our attitude has always been don't look back, you know, and just like we do exactly what we want to do at that time and how we feel at that time. And, you know, if we'd listened to what people had told us to do, you know, we wouldn't be a good group at all. You know, it wouldn't be our group, it would be somebody else's group. You know, that's the whole point. We're doing our thing, you know. I don't need anybody to tell me what to do. The kind of music that we listen to, you know, it's very diverse.
What do you listen to at home then? Have you changed completely what you listen to now as you listened to a few years ago?
Nah, because we've always been diverse. You know, we've always liked things like the Sex Pistols, the Birds, you know, the Ronettes, John Coltrane, the MC5, stuff like that. You know, anything that kind of moves, you know, Chic, Public Enemy's Limited. Most people that you speak to, you know, especially people that like that kind of like independent rock music thing, they like a certain kind of band with a certain kind of haircut, you know? And we've never been like that. We've always like been into like a lot of different things.
So what was Top of the Pops like then?
That was good. It felt really good.
I was under the impression you were going to trash the studio.
Nah, that would have been silly, wouldn't it?
Sorry?
That would have been silly. I think it's much more constructive to like hit a policeman with a brick or attack certain politicians. You know, I think that's a far better thing to do than smash up a TV studio. You know, I think that's kind of like pointless. It's as pointless as trashing a hotel room, you know? If you're going to be violent, then I think you should channel your violence in the right direction. And I think the right direction is, you know, people that break up strikes, you know, people that cannot destroy the health service. I think it would be really good to be a superstar.
Why?
Why? Because the good times would get better, I think.
Surely that's been a bit naive. It could go downhill, couldn't it?
Oh, that would be great as well. Oh, there's a better chance of it going downhill, you know. But I'm sure that if our group were superstars, then we would be complete burnouts pretty quickly. You know, we'd make some great records, but then we would get totally wasted. That's good, I think. I think it's really healthy. I like it when people just fall to bits. It's good. I don't think it matters how short a life you have. I think as long as you enjoy yourself. Some people live to be 70 or 80 and they have miserable times, you know. Some people die when they're 21 and they've had, like, a fantastic life. I don't really think it matters when you die. I think you just got to have a good time all the time, if possible.
I was under the impression that you do live, breathe and sleep music. What would happen if it was taken away from you?
What? You mean if I was put in a mental institution? Or if I went deaf.
What if you went deaf or something like that? How would you cope with it?
May as well kill myself, I suppose.
Could you not find any other outlet for yourself?
No, I'd have to kill myself. Oh, I don't think I could live without music. It means too much to me. I need music. More than I need anything else. Or anybody else.